Stay tuned in and you're going to hear some very interesting things. Pastor Jennings, how are you today?
Fine, Miss Pat.
And Jesus loves you, I know.
Yes, ma'am.
Amen.
And I love him too, Dr. Pat.
Well, you've been a street ministry for how long?
Going on about 13 years, 13, 14 years.
You know, it's the most excited ministry in the body of Christ.
Yes, ma'am.
And you were mentioning to me that many people that have known you in the past, that when you went out on the street, some of your pastoral friends lost respect for you. Is that not just an absolute spiritual crime?
Well, I view it as, not fully understanding the concept of a ministry, but if people would look at the Bible itself and look at how Jesus was conveyed himself and traveled through different villages, Dr. Pat, to meet different people, and that's what street ministry does.
That's right.
He sends me to different areas of the city to meet different people, so it's exciting to minister to new people.
Well, you know, Jesus's ministry started out announcing that he was the Son of God in the synagogue. But then after that, you see him on boats, you see him on sides of mountains, and you see him out in the street with people just thronging around him. So I believe that Jesus is walking Jacksonville with you,
yes,
Brother Lorenzo.
Thank you, Dr. Pat.
I really do. And of course, when you're out there on the street, you see some of the most phenomenal things. And I want you to mention one or two of those. But first, I heard an interesting testimony about you, how you got involved in the street ministry. I love that story. Would you just tell us about it?
Well, I was in prison ministry for about 5 years, and all of a sudden, it was just urgent to go out. And one day I was talking to some friends of mine on the east side near Autel Stadium where I grew up, and they were congregated around this fire barrel where we all used to drink, and we were talking, and they were so glad to see me and to see my life had altered. Mm-hmm. And I left, and as I was buying some car products, the Lord spoke to me and told me that they were hungry. And I immediately got out of the line out of Discount Auto Parts, and I bought 12 pieces of Popeye's chicken and 4 cups of ice water, and went back up to the corner where they were around the fire barrel, and we prayed over the chicken, and that's how the ministry ignited, over 12 pieces of Popeye's chicken and 4 cups of ice water.
Wow, that's Jesus.
And went on from there to renting the Ritz Theater and La Villa Museum 3 different times.
Oh my, and you've seen miracles and signs and wonders happen out there, and people just absolutely destitute.
Oh yes.
And you know, when Jesus went into that synagogue to announce that he had come, he said that one of the purposes was to preach the gospel to the poor. And you know, there are people out on that street that are former pastors, prophets. There are people out there that are former doctors and lawyers and businessmen. I remember I ministered to a man who built some of the biggest buildings right here in Jacksonville.
Wow.
That had gotten caught up in crack. So it's a valid, wonderful ministry. And you know, Jesus doesn't look at us about how much money do you have? How many cars do you have? Do you have the biggest ministry in town? Are you living in a $5 million home? No, the souls are important.
Yes.
For him, because that's who he died for.
Yes.
So I commend you, brother.
Thank
and
you.
I thank
yes.
you for coming yes. and being with us today.
And
Rick Yarber is an old friend of mine for many, many years. He helped us to get established over in our church in Arlington, built the stage, the platform for
wow.
us, and helped us to set up our equipment. And he's like a son to me, and I appreciate
wow.
him very, very much.
Amen.
So, Rick Yarbrough.
Yes, ma'am.
How are you today?
Glorious, thank you.
You're
glad
glorious.
To be here.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Well, you know, you don't talk much about yourself, but you have a very interesting life, to say the least.
Yes, ma'am.
And we're not really going to zero in on what the devil did before
That's
Jesus
right.
came, but you didn't come from such a ritzy, nice
yeah,
place.
No, no, no.
And so even after you grew up, the devil had a hold of your life.
Mm-hmm.
And even under those demonic anointings, you did a lot.
Yes.
And so I would like to first start and talk about a couple of your albums.
Oh.
I know that you started out with a group.
Many, many years ago, it seems like another lifetime ago since I've been saved, another person when I think about it. I was on the first of this early Lynyrd Skynyrd recordings, and this is the CD right here. It's mm-hmm. called Lynyrd Skynyrd and Friends, and I'm on two songs on it. I wrote it and mm-hmm. played on bass on some of them.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, Alan Collins was my best friend, and Gary Rosling also. And then they just went into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame 2006. So after that happened, stuff that we wrote got released, the Alan Collins project right here. Of songs mm-hmm. that me and Alan Collins wrote and Gary Rosin, and the whole story's on the back about it. And it's not in the stores yet because it's just been cut and we're looking for a distributor. But the songs on here were from 1978, right after the plane crashed, to about 1982.
I want to mention that I have seen your platinum record.
Is that what it is? Yes, ma'am. Platinum and gold.
Yeah, I have seen
album,
that.
Actually.
Yeah, I have seen that. And so I know that what you say is the truth,
yes,
because
ma'am.
I've seen it personally.
Right.
And so then what else did you do?
Well, I've got several Christian albums. This is Blues Above. This one played on the Christian radio for a long time. And I got a couple of music videos that played on the Christian television, you know, out
mm-hmm.
of this one. And
mm-hmm.
one of the songs I'm singing today is off this album, you know.
I see.
And I got about three or four altogether Christian CDs.
Uh-huh. And so you're totally submitted to
Sold
Jesus.
Out to Jesus, amen.
But I want to ask you just a few moments about Lynyrd Skynyrd Band,
okay.
because that's who you're talking about, and all of them,
they're all
one
deceased except one original
except
member.
Except you and that
one original member, Gary Rosden. He's one of the original members. He's still going.
Okay.
The rest of them all new people.
Now,
in the band.
Isn't it true that some of them got saved before they?
Well, I led Alan Collins to Jesus several times.
Uh huh.
Wow.
And
several
what
times.
About David Wilkerson?